All India Radio presents Morning News. Good morning, I'm Saira Mujtaba. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi to be conferred United Nations Highest Environmental Honour, UNEP Champions of the Earth Award in New Delhi today. Prime Minister says International Solar Alliance can replace OPEC as a key global energy supplier in future. Justice Ranjan Gogoi to be sworn in as the 46th Chief Justice of India this morning. Agitating farmers call off their protest in New Delhi. In Jammu and Kashmir, security forces recover huge cache of arms from a terrorist hideout in Doda. And in football, India thrashed Maldives by 8-0 in SAFF Under-18 Women's Championship in Thimphu, Bhutan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be conferred the United Nations Highest Environmental Honour, the UNEP Champions of the Earth Award, at a special ceremony in New Delhi today. The award will be presented by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres. The Prime Minister will also address the gathering. Our correspondent reports that the award was announced on 26th of last month on the sidelines of 73rd UN General Assembly in New York.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi and French President Emmanuel Macron have been jointly selected as the recipients of the prestigious award for their exemplary leadership and advocating action on sustainable development and climate change. Mr. Modi has been selected in the leadership category for his pioneering work in championing the International Solar Alliance and for his unprecedented pledge to eliminate all single-use plastic in India by 2022. The annual prize is awarded to outstanding leaders from government, civil society and the private sector whose actions have had a positive impact on the environment. Ashish, AIR News, Delhi.
All India Radio Delhi will broadcast live the presentation of UN Environment Champions of the Earth Award to Prime Minister Narendra Modi at Pravasi Bharatiya Kendra in New Delhi today. It can be heard on Rajdhani and FM Rainbow channels from 11:25 a.m. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that International Solar Alliance, or ISA, can replace the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, or OPEC, in the future as key supplier of energy for the world. Inaugurating the first assembly of the ISA in New Delhi last evening, Mr. Modi said, in future, the group of solar resource-rich nations will have the same role that is being played by the OPEC currently. The Prime Minister said,
मेरा हमेशा से ये मानना रहा है कि दुनिया की ऊर्जा आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति के लिए जो भूमिका आज ओपेक निभा रहा है वही भूमिका आने वाले समय में इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस आइसा की होने वाली है। जो लोग आज तेल के कुओं का है वही रोल भविष्य में सूर्य की किरणों का होने वाला है।
Mr. Modi said humans have in the last 150 to 200 years relied on resources trapped below the Earth's surface for meeting energy needs. However, he said resources available above the ground like solar and wind energy need to be harnessed. The Prime Minister called for connecting solar energy supply across borders and mooted the idea of one world, one sun, one grid.
Ved se lekar ke yog tak surya hamare chintan hamari upasana हमारी आंतरिक ऊर्जा का स्रोत रहा अब इस आंतरिक ऊर्जा को आधुनिक विज्ञान की शक्ति के साथ हम बाहरी ऊर्जा के समाधान में बदलने के लिए कटिबद्ध हैं वर्ल्ड वन वन सन वन ग्रिड इस सपने को लेकर के हम चलेंगे तो कभी भी कहीं पर भी जब तक सूरज ढलता नहीं है बिजली पाना असंभव नहीं होगा और सूरज कहीं न कहीं तो होता ही है तो फिर बिजली का प्रवाह क्यों बंद होगा
Mr. Modi said India will generate 40% of power from non-fossil fuels by 2030. He said in the last 4 years, $42 billion have been invested in clean energy in India. Speaking on the occasion, UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres said, it is India where we are going to see global renewable energy revolution and solar energy is at the center of this revolution. Justice Ranjan Gogoi will be sworn in as Chief Justice of India today. President Ramnath Kovind will administer him the oath of office at a function at the Rashtrapati Bhavan this morning. He will succeed Justice Deepak Mishra, who retired as the Chief Justice of India yesterday. Justice Gogoi will be the 46th Chief Justice of India. He will have a tenure of a little over 13 months and will retire on November 17, 2019. Born on 18th November 1954, Justice Gogoi was enrolled as an advocate in 1978. He was appointed as Chief Justice of Punjab and Haryana High Court in February 2011 and then a judge of the Supreme Court in April 2012. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts. Agitating farmers called off their protest at Delhi's Kisan Ghat, the memorial of Chaudhary Charan Singh, in the wee hours today. Speaking to AIR, agitation leader Rakesh Tikait said that farmers are now satisfied with the government's approach towards the agitation. He said government should now fulfill their promises to farmers made yesterday. Mr. Tikait said,
राजघाट तक हमारी यात्रा थी, इस यात्रा का समापन हो गया है और लोग अब अपने घरों की तरफ अब जा रहे हैं। यही लोगों से अपील की जा रही है कि आप अपने घरों की तरफ शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से चलें।
In Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh Principal Secretary Information Avnish Awasthi also confirmed that the agitation is over now. The central government allowed the farmers to enter the national capital in the early hours this morning, ending the standoff between the police personnel and protesting farmers. Farmers' leaders had a long discussion yesterday over their demands with Home Minister Rajnath Singh. In Jammu and Kashmir, security forces have busted a terrorist hideout in Doda district and recovered a huge cache of arms and ammunition. These include two AK-47 rifles with 335 rounds of ammunition, four UBGL grenades, one grenade thrower and three magazines. Talking to AIR this morning, State Director General of Police Dilbagh Singh said security officials said 10 Rashtriya Rifles troops came across the hideout during routine search operations. Mr. Singh said,
Doda mein aap jante hain ki militancy kisi waqt bahut बड़े पैमाने पर चल रही थी और अभी भी मिलिटेंट्स के जखीरे जो वेपन जहां पर ये रखते थे वो कहीं कहीं कुछ हाइड आउट्स के ऊपर मौजूद हैं। ये हमारे फोर्सेस और पुलिस ने किसी खास इतला पर मिलकर किसी हाइड आउट की सर्च करी थी जिसमें काफी असला और अमनिशन और बाकी को जो मटीरियल जो है मिला है, ये फोर्सेज के लिए एक अच्छी कामयाबी है और मैं समझता हूँ कि इस तरह के और भी जो इलाके जिस एरियाज में मिलिटेंट्स के हाइड आउट पहले रहे हैं उनको सर्च करने की जरूरत है और इसके लिए एक्शन जारी है।
In Himachal Pradesh, 10 days after heavy snowfall had completely blocked Manali-Keelong Road, Water Roads Organization has cleared the over 13,000 feet high Rohtang Pass, restoring vehicular traffic in the region. Spokesman of the Kullu District Administration said that the Manali-Keelong Road was thrown open for vehicular traffic yesterday. In Tamil Nadu, small businesses are flourishing thanks to Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana. The scheme is aimed at providing loans of up to 10 lakh rupees to non-corporate, non-farm, small or micro enterprises to facilitate business needs. Here is a ground report from our Chennai correspondent.
The PM Mudra Yojana has led many to economic independence, apart from freeing them from the claws of high-interest private lending. Ms. Punita Chidambaram from the backward district of Ariyalur has this to say.
I decided to open a flexboard unit as the industry has impressive growth prospects. When I approached the SBI for loans, their field officials suggested availing Mudra loan. When I applied through the district industry center, they immediately sanctioned the loan. This Mudra scheme has really paved the way for me to come up in life.
Mr. James from Tuticorin, who runs a provision store, says he was able to expand his business using Mudra loan.
With the Mudra loan, I was able to move my shop to a new and spacious complex and add more inventories. Now things are improving.
As the number of youth in the age group of 15 to 24 years is set to reach 34.33% of total population by 2020, Mudra loan is said to empower many of them to stand on their own, besides reviving rural economy. Jay Singh, AIR News, Chennai.
Odisha government has launched the state's own food security scheme to cover the poor. Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik yesterday launched the scheme via video conferencing at the Secretariat in Bhubaneswar. As per the provisions of the scheme, 25 lakh poor people left out from the benefits of the National Food Security Act will get 5 kilograms of rice per month. The government will spend 442 crore rupees per year for implementation of the scheme. Iraq's parliament has elected a veteran Kurdish politician Barham Saleh as the country's new president. He has named Shiite Adil Abdul Mehdi as the prime minister of the country. The move will pave the way to form a new government nearly 5 months after national elections. State TV said Patriotic Union of Kurdistan leader Sohle won 220 votes out of the 273 lawmakers who attended yesterday's session. Under an official agreement dating back to the 2003 US-led invasion, Iraq's presidency, a largely ceremonial role, is held by a Kurd, while the prime minister is Shia and the parliament speaker is Sunni. Iraq held elections on May 12. The prime minister-designate will then have 30 days to submit his cabinet to parliament. In Afghanistan, at least 13 people were killed and 30 others injured when a suicide bomber attacked an election rally in the eastern province of Nangarhar yesterday. Spokesman of the provincial governor said a militant blew himself up at the rally of parliamentary candidate Abdul Nasir Muhammad in Kam district. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo will pay a fresh visit to North Korea on Sunday and meet leader Kim Jong-un as the administration's hopes rise of a denuclearization deal. State Department said the rare advance announcement of a meeting with the young strongman came hours after North Korea raised the stakes in negotiations, saying it will not give up its nuclear weapons in exchange for a peace treaty. Pompeo, who is trying to arrange a second summit between Kim and U.S. President Donald Trump, will also head to U.S. allies Japan and South Korea, as well as North Korea's chief ally China, with which the U.S. is engaged in escalating trade and diplomatic disputes. India thrashed Maldives by a mammoth 8-0 scoreline in the second Group A match of the South Asian Football Federation Under-18 Women's Championship in Thimphu, Bhutan yesterday. With this win, India have secured top spot in Group A and have booked themselves a place in the semi-finals of the competition. India now wait for the Group B match between Nepal and Bangladesh in order to find out who they will face in the semi-final. And now for an overview of today's newspapers, it's over to Tanvi Taneja.
Thank you, Sarah. The farmers' protest march towards Delhi is the lead story in almost all newspapers today. The Hindustan Times writes, "Farmers' march sparks clashes on Delhi border." The DNA headlines, "Farmers dig in their heels, will continue stir until demands met," adding, "Prohibitory orders imposed after Kisan rally turns violent." The Indian Express headlines, "S-400 missile deal to be signed during Putin's India visit this week," says Moscow. Tussle between BJP and Congress over Mahatma's legacy has been prominently noticed by the newspapers. The Asian Age says BJP-Congress locked in a tug of war over Gandhi legacy, while the Hindu reports Congress calls for new freedom struggle. In a bid to assuage privacy concerns related to Aadhaar, the Times of India headlines, "Now government pushes offline tools to verify Aadhaar." The probe into financial irregularities at the Infrastructure Leasing and Financial Services, or IL&FS, is also widely covered across dailies. The Economic Times says SFIO begins quizzing IL&FS brass, while the Indian Express notes IL&FS mess got deeper, but its top risk committee never met in last 2 years. With Haryana government announcing procurement of bajra at MSP, huge stocks from Rajasthan find their way in its grain markets. The Tribune writes, "Driven by profit, bajra from Rajasthan in Haryana for MSP." In another story, the Pioneer reports, "Brent oil hits 4-year high of $85 per barrel on Iran sanction." Donna Strickland, becoming the first woman in 55 years to win the Nobel Physics Prize, has been widely covered. The Statesman writes, "Laser pioneers win Nobel Physics Prize," while the DNA reports, "Strickland is third woman ever to win Nobel for Physics. She shares the prize with Arthur Ashkin and Gerard Muro." And finally, India's famed geological features are set to be featured on the global stage with the Geological Survey choosing heritage sites in Maharashtra and Karnataka for the Geopark tag. 88 million year old isle and crater to be geoparks, writes the Hindu. And with that, it's back to you, Sarah.
Thank you, Sanvi. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi to be conferred United Nations Highest Environmental Honour, UNEP Champions of the Earth Award in New Delhi today. Prime Minister says International Solar Alliance can replace OPEC as a key global energy supplier in future. Justice Ranjan Gogoi to be sworn in as the 46th Chief Justice of India this morning. Agitating farmers call off their protest in New Delhi. In Jammu and Kashmir, security forces recover huge cache of arms from a terrorist hideout in Doda. And in football, India thrashed Maldives by 8-0 in SAFF Under-18 Women's Championship in Thimphu, Bhutan. For details of these stories and more, log on to our website www.newsonair.nic.in. With that, we end the morning news. Have a great day.